now here we are going to learn about the deserts now. Terrestrial, that is what? Terrestrial adaptation we were talking in that. Now we are learning about the deserts. Deserts, you know, deserts are dry areas of land that receives little or no rainfall. Yes or no? Most deserts are very hot during the day and very cold at night. Due to minimal rainfall, minimal means very less rainfall, these places are mostly barren of vegetation. Barren of vegetation means there will be no vegetation or very less vegetation, because no water means no plants. No plants means no vegetation. Okay. So the following are examples of plants and animals found in desert. Now even in the plant, that is in deserts, we can see some plants. Which are the plants we can see are cactus, date palm, acacia and agave. What about the animals? Even there are animals which are found, that is camels, kangaroos, rats, thorny devils, lizards and rattlesnakes. These are found in deserts. Now how do they adapt? With less water also they stay there, right? So the plants, how they adapt, you know, most desert plants have long roots to absorb water deep in the soil. Okay, they will be deep roots inside. Then in cactus, you have seen the cactus plant. Now you can see the cactus here, this side, this is a cactus plant here. This and this both are cactus, you can see there. Now what about the leaves of this? Can you see the leaves? Leaves are modified as spines. You can see the spines here. Yes, the leaves you can make out. There are spines here. These spines help them. Spines and the stem has a waxy coating to prevent water loss. So it will help to prevent the water loss. The green fleshy stem store water and also make food for the plant. Leaves are reduced or absent in most desert plants. So leaves will not be there. Why? Because from leaves the transpiration takes place. What is the meaning of transpiration? Means the absorption of water and removal of water which will be in the leaves. But here the leaves itself will not be there because there is scarcity of water. So the most of the desert plants will not have leaves in them. Now what about the animals here? Animals, desert animals such as kangaroo, rats and desert snakes avoid excess heat by remaining in shade or in underground burrows during the day. So it will not come in the hot sun. It will hide itself in the shades and inside the ground like that. You can see it will be below the earth so that the hot sun, if it is in the hot sun, it needs more water. So it will hide in the sun. Then excess food is stored in fat and its humps. Okay. These fats broken down to get energy when required. Long thick eyelashes. You have seen the camel, no? Right? A camel, now you can see here. This is known as the ship of the desert, right? Camel is known as what? The ship of desert. Why? Because it runs very fast in the desert area. Now how does it has been developed itself? Means a camel can survive without food or water for days. For many days it can stay. Excess food is stored as fat. Here this is the hump of the camel where the excess food and water is stored. It needs hump. This fat is broken down to get energy when required. If it is hungry for two, three days, no, from where does it gets the energy? From this hump, okay. In its hump, already energy will be stored. From that, it can be alive for so many days. Not only that, long, thick eyelashes. You can see long, thick eyelashes here and flaps over the nostril, this side. Prevents sand from entering the camel eyes and nose. Desert places, you know, sand will be more. Right? So it can enter in the eyes and nose. For that, God have made the big eyelashes and the nostrils also are little big so that the dust should not enter in them. Now the next is the mountain regions. So mountains, you know, right? You have already seen, you like to go to the mountainous places, right? Okay. Mountain regions are the areas that are present on hills and mountains. they are normally cold and windy. Yes or no? It will be cold and windy there. Some even receive snowfall. The examples now for the plants and animals which live here are pine. For plants, it is pine tree, larch, spruce, and fire. Okay, F-I-R, fire. Now here, animals, that is snow leopard, yaks, and mountain goats. Snow leopards and yaks, you can see here, right? Okay, how do they adapt themselves here? The plants, because it will be very cold here, trees such as pine and fir are cone-shaped with sloping branches. You can see the different types of trees. Because of different weather, different adaptation, they will take their own way to survive there. That is known as adaptation there. Now here, what do they have? They have cone shape with sloping branches and needle shaped leaves. These help snow and rainwater slide off them easily. Otherwise, the branches might break under the weight of the snow. Okay, if the snow will be staying there, then the branches will fall off. So it should be sliding way. So once the snow is falling, it will slide and it will fall down. It will not stay here. Okay, so the plant can survive. What about the animals? How do they survive in the cold areas? Means a yak. Yak, you can see here. A yak has long hairs that keeps it warm. A snow leopard has thick fur. Okay, snow leopard will have thick fur. You can see the snow leopard here. A snow leopard has thick fur so that it will keep it warm even over its paws. Paws means the legs. This is known as the paws. Paws of leopard, which protect it while walking in the snow. A mountain goat has hooves feet. You can see here, this is the mountain goats. It will be having hooves, that is the legs will be broader. A mountain goat has tough hooves feet that help it climb rocky areas. Now here we are going to learn about the aquatic habitat. Seeing whale fish, you can see, right? Okay, now which are the aquatic habitats? Aquatic habitats are rivers, ponds, lakes, and freshwater bodies. They are also known as freshwater habitats. Okay, freshwater habitats where the water itself is different. Which are those? Rivers, ponds, lakes, freshwater bodies. Now, which are the plants which grows in this? Is the lotus, water lily, water hyacinth, and algae. Now, what about the animals? Animals first comes is the fish, right? Fish, then ducks, frogs, snakes, and crocodiles. Now, what about the other? Not only river ponds. We have one more also, no? Big, that is oceans and seas, right? Oceans and seas are marine habitat. Why we say marine? Because the water is salty there. Therefore, we say it as marine habitats. These are large water bodies that contain salty water. Ocean and seas are large water bodies that contain salty water. They occupy about 3/4 of our planet. Now, example of the plants is seaweed and algae. What about the animals? Blue whales, sharks, octopus, jellyfish, sardines, tuna, and unicellular organisms which can be found in oceans and seas. Now, how do these adapt themselves? Plants, since water is readily available, most aquatic plants have highly reduced roots. So, plants have their highly reduced roots. Roots, stems, and leaves of most aquatic plants have air spaces that help them float in water. So, already water is available, so it cannot absorb all the water. If it absorbs water, it will be rotten. So, what happens here? They have air spaces that helps them to float in water. Leaves of most aquatic plants have a waxy coating to prevent them from rotting. Okay. So, it will be slippery, waxy type. You know the wax or the, once we put anything, it will float down. Like that, the aquatic plants will have. Plants such as hydrilla, which grow underwater, have flexible stem. Okay, hydrilla grows inside the water. We cannot see the hydrilla plant above. So this will be inside, and how it will survive means it has flexible stem and narrow ribbon-like leaves, so that water can flow without tearing the leaves. Okay, tearing the leaves. What about the animals? How do they adapt themselves there? Means fishes have fins, tails, and streamlined body. You can see tails, fins, and streamlined body, which helps them move through water. They also have special organs called gills for breathing under water. Animals such as octopus, here you can see this is octopus, then squid, jellyfish, form a streamlined shape while swimming, which helps them move from water easily. Whales and dolphins have nostrils or blue holes on top of their heads for breathing. So this is the blue hole which you can see, okay, on the top. So which help them for breathing. These animals come to surface to take in air. Okay. So now you have understood what I have explained. You have to do little homework in this. So you can see here, choose the correct options, fill in the blanks, and name the following. This you have to write the questions and answer in the classwork. We have till here you have to do. Okay, name the following till here you have to do. Now this, where will you write in the classwork? You have to make two halves of it. So the second half will be the homework column. In that you have to write. Thank you.